Prevagen improves memory. You've probably seen that claim on television commercials for a memory supplement called Prevagen, but is it actually true? The only way to really know is to take a look at the actual research, and there is research on Prevagen. Let's take a look at that right now. So as supplements go, Prevagen's pretty straightforward. It only has one key ingredient, and that's an extract of jellyfish called apoaequorin. Apoaequorin is said to work by removing excess calcium from the brain. And to be clear, there is some research suggesting that elevated calcium levels in the brain are linked to decreased cognitive function. So it makes sense that if you could remove that excess calcium from the brain, memory problems might improve. Prevagen also contains a good amount of vitamin D, which on the surface may seem paradoxical because vitamin D is well known to increase calcium absorption. That said, Prevagen likely contains vitamin D because of various studies like this one indicating that vitamin D supplements appear to improve memory in older folks who have mild memory impairment. Other studies suggest that vitamin D may work best at improving memory in those who already have low levels of this nutrient, which includes many older adults. Okay, that's nice, but the proof is in the pudding. What's the evidence that Prevagen supplements improve memory? Fortunately, the company that makes Prevagen, they're called Quincy Biosciences, they've supported research on their supplement, and that's a good thing. Let's take a look at those studies now. If you go to the Prevagen website, you'll see that they list three safety studies on Prevagen and one clinical trial in humans that they call the Madison Memory Study. So the first investigation of Prevagen was a safety study. It came out in 2013, and it was reported that there were no observed negative side effects when rats were given super high doses of the apoaequorin jellyfish extract protein. This was followed up by another safety study in which rats also were given very high doses of apoaequorin, and it was found to not cause any allergic reactions. Additionally, it's also reported here that the apoaequorin protein was, quote, easily digested by protein digesting enzymes in the stomach. Wait a minute, the key ingredient in Prevagen is easily digested in the stomach? If that's so, how does it get into the brain to remove excess calcium? Let's stick a pin in that for a later conversation. The third safety study also found that even higher doses of the apoaequorin protein were found to be safe in female rats. And that brings us to the flagship study of Prevagen with the makers of the supplement called the Madison Memory Study. And it's called Madison Memory Study after Madison, Wisconsin, which is where Quincy Biosciences is located. 218 men and women between the ages of 40 and 91 are included in this 3-month randomized placebo-controlled study where people are given either a placebo or 10 milligrams of the apoaequorin jellyfish protein each day. And I want to point out that 10 milligrams of apoaequorin is the exact amount that's found in Prevagen. So that's good. Now, I do want to point out here that to be included in the Madison Memory Study, people had to be concerned about their memory. However, they were excluded from this study if they were formally diagnosed with a doctor as having memory impairment problems, such as dementia or Alzheimer's disease. These people were given a battery of 9 before and after memory tests. So what did they find? So the first thing to realize is that there were no significant differences in improvements in memory between the Prevagen takers and the placebo takers. And that bears repeating. There were no significant improvements in memory between either those people who took Prevagen or those who took a placebo. Now, for some, that might mean that Prevagen doesn't work, but hold on. The company says that when they drilled down further and only looked at those people who were not memory impaired who took Prevagen supplements, those people showed about 11% improvement in their ability to remember items on a shopping list. They also reported a small but significant effect of about 6% improvement in these non-memory impaired people's ability to recall items on a shopping list after a brief delay in repeating what the items were. Now, while that might seem encouraging, one shortcoming of the Madison Memory Study is that they didn't actually measure before and after calcium levels. Remember, apoaequorin, the key ingredient in Prevagen, is supposed to work by removing excess calcium from the brain. So if you're intrigued by the commercials and you want to buy Prevagen and try it for yourself, understand that it comes in 3 flavors. There's regular strength, there's extra strength, and there's also a professional strength formula of Prevagen as well. And as you can see, the only real difference between each of these formulations is the amount of apoaequorin that each contains. And while it's normal to assume that more is better and more effective, realize that the Madison Memory Study only use the 10 milligram dose of apoaequorin. This means you can save yourself a lot of money by only using the regular strength Prevagen and not the extra strength or professional formula. So does Prevagen really work for me? I'm not yet convinced. Some of the findings of the Madison memory trial are interesting. However, let's remember that Prevagen did not improve memory better than people who took a placebo. Nonetheless, if you've watched the TV commercials, you've seen a lot of people saying that their memory appears to improve. So what do you think?